Good morning, students. We have to start from line 64, Ariel's speech. You are three men of sin, whom destiny that had to instrument this lower world. And what is in it? So, I told you in the last turn that Ariel comes disguised as a harpy. I told you what is a harpy, right? So, Ariel comes there to make these people, that is King Alonso and company, realize their sin. You are three men of sin. Who are these three men? Who are these three men referred to by Ariel? Yes, Tanisha.
Ma'am, Antonio, Sebastian, and King Alonso.
Yes, Antonio, Sebastian, and King Alonso. And what was the sin they have committed? Which sin is Ariel talking about? Shishti, please unmute and answer. So Ariel says, you are three men of sin, whom destiny. See, destiny has been personified, the goddess of destiny. Okay, it's being referred to here. So you are three men of sin. You are the people who have committed sin in your lives, grave sin in your lives, whom destiny that had to instrument this lower world. What do you mean by lower world? That is this mortal world, earth and the earthly things. Lower world and what is in it? And what is in it means anything which belongs to this earth. The earth with all its components, right? Whom destiny had to instrument. Instrument means to rule. This goddess of destiny rules over the earth and everything which belongs to this earth. Everything which is in this earth. That is ruled by destiny. The never self-heated sea. Never self-heated means never satisfied, always hungry. So, never self-heated sea hath cause to belch up you. So, what has the sea done to you? The sea has thrown you out. Belch up you means has vomited you upon this island. Belching, you know. So, when you burp, run in the name of belch is burp, right? So, hath caused to belch up you. So, this always hungry sea, the sea which engulfs everything, which comes to it, swallows everything. It is always hungry. So that is why the sea has been termed as never satiated, means never satisfied. The hunger of the sea is never satiated. So, that sea has been termed as always hungry. So, hath caused to belch up you. So, this sea, what has the sea done? The sea has also thrown you, vomited you upon this island. And on this island where man doth not live. So, the sea has thrown you on this island where no human being lives. This uninhabited island where humanity is not to be found. You have been thrown upon this island by the sea. The sea also didn't swallow you, but through you, you people, all three of you have been thrown upon this island. You amongst men being most unfit to live. And why has the sun? And why has the sea done this? Because you are unfit. You are not suitable to live among humans. You have committed such heinous crime in your life. Such heinous sin in your life, you are so great sinners that you are not fit to live with human beings. So that is why the sea as a punishment has thrown you upon this lonely island where human beings don't live. I have made you mad. And then Ariel says that, and you have gone crazy. You are not in your senses. Why? Because I made you mad. I have taken control over your minds and now you people are behaving like crazy, mad people. That is because of my influence. Right? And even with such light valor, men hang and drown their professors. And in your condition, many brave men, what do they do? They either hang themselves in your condition, in your state of mind, or they drown themselves. Either they jump into the sea and drown themselves, or they hang themselves, right? In your state of mind. Their proper selves means they themselves. Then what happens? Alonso, Sebastian, and company draw their swords. What happens when they see a strange monster-like creature, half woman and half bird, sitting on the table and talking to them in this fashion? Alonso, Sebastian, and company and others, they sense danger. Right? And because they sense danger and they want to protect themselves, so they take out their swords to attack this strange creature, that is Ariel, disguised as a harpy. So they want to attack Ariel. So what does Ariel say? You fools, I and my fellows are ministers of faith. So when they draw their swords out of their scabbards, what does Ariel say? Ariel says that you foolish creatures, you are trying to attack me. You know who am I? I and these fellow spirits, these other spirits who are along with me. You remember those strange shapes which came with the feast? So he says that don't do this. Don't act like stupid creatures. I and my fellows and my companions who are here with me, they are the ministers of faith. They are the agents of faith. They are the messengers of faith. The elements of whom your swords are tempered may as well wound the loud. So he says that don't do this. Don't waste your time, energy, and effort in trying to attack us with your swords, because your swords won't be able to cause any damage to us. And then he compares. He says that wound the loud winds. Is it possible to attack the winds or to harm the winds with your sword? No, it is not. Or with the mark that stabs kill the still closing water. Is it possible to cut the water with the sword? No. What will happen if you move your sword on a water body in a river or any water body? It will again close. Right? Line will be formed, and as the sword will move, it will close. So that is what it says, kill the still closing water. So, if you will try to cut the water, it will again close and become one. You cannot cut the water. You cannot cut the wind with your sword. So, in a similar manner, you cannot harm us. That is me and my fellow spirits who are here along with me. Why? Because we are the agents of faith. We are the messengers of faith. We have been sent by the goddess of destiny to tell you something. So stop acting like fools by taking out your swords and trying to harm us, because you will not be able to do it. Kill the still closing waters, as you cannot stab the bimok means something which is jeered at, ridiculed, balked at. So till the still closing waters, as diminish one dovel that is in my feet. So you cannot, technically you cannot harm us. Plume means feather, right? So even a single feather cannot be damaged by you people, because Ariel was disguised as a bird. You know, I told you that a harpy is half woman, means face and body of a woman, and then wings of a bird, wings and claws and other parts of a bird. So that is why Ariel says that you cannot even harm one single feather. Of mine. My fellow ministers are like invulnerable. And similarly, you cannot harm me and my fellow ministers are also invulnerable. They also cannot be harmed. They also cannot be damaged by your weapons. So don't make an attempt to do it. If you could hurt, And then Ariel further says that even if it was possible for you to hurt us with your sword, then what would happen? Your swords are now too massy for your strength and will not be lifted. He says that in the first place, it is not possible for you people to harm us with your weapons, with your swords. And if it would have been possible for you to harm us with your sword, then your swords would have become so heavy. Too massy means so heavy that it would have been beyond your capacity to lift them up. If your weapons had the ability to harm us, then I would have made your weapons so heavy that you would have not been able to lift them up. For your strength and will not be lifted. So he says, in the first place, you cannot harm us, right? Like you cannot harm the water and the winds with your weapons. So he also, the metal with which your weapons are made, they are harmless to us. You cannot harm us. And in case it was possible for you to do so, then your swords would have become so massy or so heavy that it would have been beyond your capacity to even lift your foot. But remember, for that's my business. So he says, let's stop acting like fools now. Instead, pay attention. But remember, here means pay attention. Listen to me carefully, right? So, and remember, for that's my business too. Because I am here for some business, for some important work. That you three from Milan did supplant Gupta. So I am here for some important work. And so you are supposed to listen to what I have to say. Right? I have to tell you something important. So you should stop acting like fools by trying to attack us. Instead, pay attention to my words. And then what does he say? That you three from Milan did supplant Gupta. You three, all three of you, what did you do in the past? You supplant from good Prospero, means you threw out Prospero out of Milan 12 years ago. This was the sin which you did. You removed Prospero from the throne and he was thrown out of Milan, exposed unto the sea. And then he was, you remember when Prospero narrated the story of his past to his daughter Miranda, then he was exposed to the sea on a stormy night. So you threw him, you removed him from his kingdom, and then he was thrown into the sea at night, which had liquid. And what has the sea done? Sea has saved Prospero. Sea has returned Prospero. So Ariel told these three sinners that Prospero is not dead, right? Prospero was returned safely by the sea, right? Him and his innocent child. So Prospero and his innocent child, they have been requited by the sea. They have been returned by the sea and they are saved. For which foul deed, the powers delaying not forgetting. And for this foul deed which you committed in the past, the powers delaying not forgetting. The powers being the divine powers. The godly, the heavenly powers, the divine powers who do justice, right? So they have delayed your punishment. Don't think that they have forgotten your deeds which you committed in the past, the sins which you committed in the past. Those sins have not been forgotten by the gods. It's only that your punishment was delayed by 12 years. Right? Because you remember that they committed the act of throwing Prospero out of the kingdom 12 years ago. So that is what Ariel tells them, that the past, that is the divine past, they have delayed your punishment. They have not forgotten about the sins which you committed. Have incensed the sea. And now it was time for your punishment. So these divine powers, these heavenly powers, what have they done? They have incensed the sea and the shores. Incensed the sea means they have enraged. They have incited the sea and the shores. Yeah, all creatures and everything, every non-living thing present in nature and the living things present in nature, they are now against you. That is the sea and the shores are also against you, and all the living creatures are also against you, because they have been provoked, they have been enraged by the divine power, because it is the right time for your punishment against your peace. So they have been incensed against your peace. So you are no longer going to have a peaceful life. Be of thy son alone. So they have there. And how have they punished you? That is told by Aaron. He says that Alonso, you have been separated from your son. They have taken your son away from you. And do pronounce by me lingering perdition. And not only this, not only your son has been taken away, snatched away by destiny from you. There is still something more which you have to face. There is more suffering in store for you. So he says that thee of thy son Alonso they have bereft. So they have taken away your son from you, snatched away your son from you, and do pronounce by me. And I am here, because Ariel said that I am the agent of fate. I'm the messenger of fate. And so through me, fate is pronouncing its judgment or punishment for your deeds. And do pronounce by me lingering perdition. And now it is time that you, all three of you, will be punished. And what this punishment will be in the form of lingering perdition, means continuous suffering. So don't think that this is the end of your suffering. It has just started, and it will go on and on. So now your life will be full of constant suffering. You will not have peace. Peace will not be given to you. Worse than any death can be at once. Right? So, and trust me, death will not be awarded to you. Because what is death? Death means the end of suffering, the end of pain. So don't think that you people will die easily. You will go on suffering. Your life will become hell. You will live, but you will live a painful life. You will live a life full of agony, pain, and suffering. Can be at once, shall step by step. And so the suffering will increase. Your problems will increase step by step. Right? It will become more severe. You and your ways, whose wraps to guard you from. So, and if you want yourself to be guarded, to be saved from this wrath, that means anger, from this anger of the gods, what you will have to do, this has been explained by Ariel in the last line, whose wrath to guard you from, which here in this most desolate isle, else falls upon your head, is nothing but heart sorrow and a clear light. So he says that if you want to guard yourself from the anger of these gods, right, what you will have to do in this desolate isle, right? If you have been thrown upon this desolate isle, this lonely island by these gods, and you are suffering from the time you landed upon this island, and trust me, they have decided that your entire life will be full of suffering now, pain now. This could be, you will, your life will be kind of a constant suffering now. And if you want to save yourself, else falls upon your head. This suffering which has fallen upon your head, if you want to save yourself from this, then is nothing but heart sorrow. Then you will have to repent on your actions. There should be heartfelt repentance. With a true heart, you should repent on your deeds, on the sins which you have committed. Right? So, the first thing which you'll have to do is repentance, that is heart sorrow, and a clear life ensue. And the second thing which you will have to promise is that in your future, you will lead a pure life free from sin. You will have to promise, you will have to take an oath that in future, your life will not have any sin. Means you will not commit any wrong deed in your upcoming life, in your future life. So these two things, if you agree to do, if all three of you agree to do these two things, that the first thing is heartfelt repentance, and the second thing is clear life ensue. So if you're ready to do these things, then only you can be forgiven. Or else be prepared to face the repercussions, to face the consequences of your wrongdoing. He vanishes in thunder, then to soft music enter the ships. And then what happens? After saying this, Ariel was disguised as a harpy, he disappears. And then soft music is played. The shapes again and dance. And then those strange shapes, the spirits, they come and they again dance and make different mocks and moves. Mocks and moves means they make their different gestures. They're twisted facial expressions. They make and then they carry the table which was laid there. They take away the table along with them. Okay. So we'll move ahead. Then Prospero, you remember Prospero was also present there, but he was invisible to everyone, right? Nobody was able to see him. So then Prospero says to himself, he saw the performance of Ariel and his subordinate spirits. He saw how well they performed, and then he praises Ariel. Bravely the figure of this harpy has thou performed. He praises Ariel and he says that you have done a wonderful job, my Ariel. You have splendidly, in a wonderful manner, you have performed the role of a harpy. A grace it has. It was done in a very graceful manner by you. Devouring of my instructions had thou nothing bated in what thou hadest received. Bated means reduced. So you have not reduced. Devouring means you have absorbed. You have eaten up all the instructions which I gave you. Devouring means to eat up. So you have eaten up all the instructions which I gave you, right? How you were supposed to perform. So you absorbed everything. You took everything what I told you, and then you followed my instructions to the minutest detail and wonderfully performed the role of a harpy. Devouring of my instructions had thou nothing to do. You have not removed a single thing. You have not reduced a single thing from the instructions which I gave you. Not even a single point was omitted from my instructions in what thou hadest to say. So what you were supposed to say as a harpy, you said everything. So with good life and observation, strained by meaner ministers. And similarly, my meaner ministers means my lower spirit, that is the meaner spirit, the subordinate spirit. They have also done a great job. With extraordinary spirit, with extraordinary enthusiasm, they have also done their job. They have also done their job in a wonderful manner. There are several kinds of them. So these are several kinds of subordinate spirit. They have also done the way they were instructed. They have also performed excellently, brilliantly. And then he further says, my high charms work. Now my magic Now my higher magic is working on them. And these, my enemies are all knit up. And knit up means caught up. So these, my enemies, that is Alonso, Sebastian, and Antonio. What, you remember that their mind is in Prospero's control now because of his magic. They are under a magic spell. So they have started behaving like mad, crazy people. So he says, my high charms work. Now my magic has started working. And these, my enemies, and these enemies, what they are all knit up. They are completely caught up in their distractions, in their despair. Now I have made them caught up in their despair, in their sorrow, in their madness. Because now what happened? After Prospero told these people about their sins through Ariel disguised as a harpy, what happened? There will be some kind of guilt. Right? Just try and understand the situation of King Alonso. He, as it is, he was half banned because he lost his son. Right? And then somebody comes and tells him that you lost your son because of the sin which you committed years ago. So what will he feel? There will be a lot of guilt inside him. So that is why he says in their distractions. So now they have gone completely mad. Their minds are distracted. They now are in my power. So they are in my power. They are under my control. And in these fits I leave them. And I will leave them in this condition. In this madness, they will be left by me while I visit young Ferdinand. And in the meantime, what will I do? I will go and visit Ferdinand, whom they suppose is down. Whom these people, that is King Alonso and his crew, they consider him to be drowned. They think that he is drowned, he is dead. So I leave them in this condition, in this state of mind, in this crazy state of mind, and I will go back to Ferdinand and his and mine loved darling. Who is his and mine loved darling? Who is loved darling here? Miranda, right? Who Ferdinand also loves and I also love. So Miranda was the darling of Prospero also and Ferdinand also, because both of them loved her a lot. So he says that I would go back to Ferdinand and Miranda and let them be in this condition. Exit above. And then Prospero also leaves the place. Gonzalo, in the name of something holy, sir, why stand you in this strange state? So when Alonso heard what Harpy said, he was just kind of frozen. There was no movement in his body. He was just looking at one place in a state of shock and amazement, right? So Gonzalo says, Gonzalo asks him, in the name of God, in the name of heaven, sir, why are you standing in such a strange manner, staring at one place? What happened to you? Alonso, oh, it is monstrous, monstrous. So King Alonso says, that it is terrible, it's dreadful, it's horrifying. So, because this was really, this was not something normal which they saw in front of their eyes. So, he was in a state of shock. And so, when Gonzalo tries to bring him back, right, he was poked by Gonzalo, and Gonzalo asked him that, in the name of heaven, in the name of God, sir, please tell me, why are you staring at one place? So he says, oh, it is monstrous, monstrous. It's terrible. It's horrible. Me think the billows is spoken to me. Billows means the waves. So he says that I thought that these waves of the sea, they told me about it. The winds did sing it to me. These blowing winds, the winds which blow, even the winds also told me about it. And the thunder, that deep and dreadful organ pipe. And this thunder, like an organ pipe, is a musical instrument. So this thunder, the sound of this thunder, right, like an organ pipe, pronounce the name of Prospero. So he said that I could hear the name of Prospero in the waves of the sea, in the blowing wind, and in this thunder, the sound of thunder. All these things, they were uttering just one word, and that is Prospero's name. Prospero's name was everywhere. I could hear his name. It did base my trespass. So these objects of the nature, they were telling about my trespass. Trespass here means the sin. They were pronouncing my sin. They were telling me about my sin by uttering the name of Prospero. Therefore, my son in the evil spirit. And because of my son, because of my sin, because of the crime which I did, my son is buried in the ooze, that is muddy waters of the sea. My son is buried into the sea. And I'll seek him deeper than ever plummet sounded, and with him there lie. And he says, now he doesn't want to live, right? He says, and it is because of my sin. I could hear my sin being pronounced in the objects of the nature. These waves, these winds, this thunder, everything was telling me about my sin. So what will I do? I will seek him deeper. Now I am going in search of my son. My son is lying buried into the sea, in the deep muddy waters of the sea. And what will I do? I will also go to him deeper than ever plummet sounded. Then any plumb line. Plumb line is the instrument which is used by the sailors to measure the depth of the sea, right? So deeper than any plumb line can ever reach, I will also go seeking my son. Seeking my son means in search of my son. I will also jump into the sea and I will also be drowned. And with him there lie, and will lie with him deep down in the bottom of the sea. Sebastian, but one peon at a time, I'll fight their legions over. So legions means the armies, large number of people. He says that he becomes aggressive, right? I told you earlier also that Sebastian and Antonio are very aggressive people from the Act 1, Scene 1, right? So Sebastian says, but one peon at a time, I'll fight their legions over. He says that if they come one by one, right? If one enemy attacks me at a time, right, then I'm ready to fight their entire armies. Even if there are large number of people, I'll be able to fight them. I'll be able to defeat them. The only condition is that they should come and attack me one by one, not in a group. Antonio, I'll be thy second. So Antonio says, yes, fine, we can fight these strange creatures. And I'll be thy second means I am along with you. I will come and support you in this mission. It's in Sebastian and Antonio. And then they want to fight these strange enemies, right? These strange creatures of the island. And they leave the scene with their sword. Gonzalo, all three of them are desperate. So Gonzalo understands and he says that all three of them have gone mad. They are not in their senses, like their great guilt. And why are they not there in their senses? Because of their guilt. Because they were made to realize their sin after so many years by a strange creature like Harpy on this lonely, uninhabited island. They were told about their suffering and the cause of their suffering. So he says that all three of them are desperate. Desperate here means not in their proper state of mind. Their great guilt, like poison given to work a great time. And their great guilt, the guilt of the sin which they committed. Now what has happened? It has started working like poison. How does poison work? If you consume poison, you will not die instantly, right? There are some kind of poisons who take some time, right, to start having an impact on you. They will not have an immediate impact. Instead, they will start working after some time. So he says that their guilt is now acting like poison, given to work a great time later. like a poison which acts slowly. So it took, their kill took 12 years. So that is why it has been compared to a poison which acts after some time, which takes time to show its effect. So poison given to work a great time after, now begins to bite their spirit. So now their guilt has started pinching their spirit, troubling their spirit, like the poison which takes long time to show its impact. I do beseech you that are of suppler joint. Then Gonzalo requests the others in the group, that is Francisco, Adrian, all these people were also there. Na? So he says, because Gonzalo is an old fellow, so he says, I do request you, I beg you, that are of suppler joint. That are of suppler joint means those are very agile and those who are young and active, right? I do request you people, follow them swiftly. Please go after them, because all three of them left. Alonso left because he wanted to jump into the sea. Antonio and Sebastian left the place because they wanted to fight these strange creatures, that is the strange spirits of the island, right? So he went to attack them. Alonso went to jump into the sea, right? He wanted to jump into the sea, so he also left the place. And Gonzalo, being an old fellow, it was not easy for him to run after them and stop them from acting like bad people. So he requests Adrian and Francisco and others in the group, those who are of suppler joints, means those who are more, those whose joints are more flexible and more agile, follow them swiftly. Please go after them quickly and hinder them from what this ecstasy may now permit them to. So he says that, please go after them. You people can run fast. You go after them and stop them from what this ecstasy means. This is disturbed state of mind. They are not in their senses. They have gone crazy. So in this crazy state of mind, they might act in a foolish manner. So you please go, you people run, and you stop them from doing some stupid act, from committing some wrong act, right? So he requests the younger people in the Adrian, follow, I pray. So Adrian agrees to run, and then he says that, I pray you that you follow, you come slowly, we are going at a faster pace to stop these people. And then all of them leave the sea. With this, we come to the end of Act 3, Scene 3.